3D printing is always the hard topic that I want to try for a long time, and I'm also aware of the complexity and difficulty of it. It requires a specialized knowledge like 3D modeling. It needs a lot of practice and adjustments, which are the factors keeping me away from 3D printing. So when I saw this Mijia 3D printer, which is featured with auto parameter adjustments, easy access with a simplified process, I of course have to give a try. But is it really helpful for the beginner like me? That is a big question mark. Because it seems that Mijia is producing everything nowadays, but not every product they made is a good one. So how about this printer? Hit the subscribe button and we're getting into the content right away. Hey there, welcome to Test TV, a channel you will always get the honest answers. So this is the Mijia 3D printer. It is a resin UV photocurrying printer, which is a type of printer that has a slow printing speed and lack of material strength, but comes with more precision if you compare with the other types. This only has 2K resolution, which basically is the lowest resolution in the UV photocurrying printers. And you cannot use the other resin printing material, but only the one provided by Mijia itself. Just like the other Mijia product, it comes with an app. And you will know what does it do once you open it, which is the content we'll dive into later. But now we need to assemble this machine. You just need to attach the printing platform and the container, then plug in the material tank, as simple as it is. Enough talking, let's start printing. But considering this is my first time, I decided to go for something simple, a radish knife for example. Select the model, it will automatically analyze the layout and generate support structures. The process will start as soon as we press the button. The resin will be extracted from the material tank to the container first. Then it's ready to print. But I need to remind you that this process will generate a very unpleasant smell, so you'd better place it at somewhere close to the window. When printing starts, you will see the printing platform slowly sinking into the container. And every bit it descends, the UV light will illuminate from the button to cure it. It will be repeating this process for countless times, and the taller model is, the longer time it will take. So these tiny components are the result of 8 hours work. Next, I have to clean it up in order to remove the sticky excess resin from the surface. Then remove the support for next curing. Place the prints on a turntable, close the cover, press to start, but remember do not try to shorten the time because every single corner of the structure needs to be properly illuminated by the UV light. Otherwise, that would weaken the strength of the structure. At last, polish and install it, a 3D printing radish knife is created. Things are going pretty well so far, isn't it? But the problem occurs soon after that. Maybe we were not being precise enough on modeling, or maybe the printing is lack of accuracy. Nevertheless, the radish knife doesn't feel smooth enough to play with. And the worst is, it is much more fragile than expected. It turns out the resin material from Mijia is very brittle after curing. It is not the ideal material for printing moving components like this. So I have to try something fixed without moving parts. Therefore, we choose the GWM Tank 300 that we reviewed before, which is a pretty good car when it comes to off-road performance, so click that link to watch the video if you're interested. But after I inputted the model, I have realized that I have underestimated the complexity of it, which is a difficult work to do for this printer. The supports the generator covers in and out of the car. The outer part could be carefully removed, but the inner part is a real tough issue. And due to the characteristic of resin material, it is not able to print out the details on the bumper. So we tried to print it vertically because technically that wouldn't magnify the details, so it would be easier for the machine to generate the model. But for people who doesn't familiar with 3D printing, it is hard to have well control of the details. And even though if we can print it bigger to preserve the details of the bumper, but that would make the model even more fragile. And the thinner parts of the body would swell up after curing. The interior is still fully filled with the supports. If you want to get rid of those extra supports, you need to build the supports yourself in advance. But again, that is not a practical solution for the beginners. The next model we decided to print is something useful. A Mac mini stand with a simple structure. Everything was looking fine when modeling and previewing the app, but what we got after is the opposite. Maybe the printer thought the model was too simple, so they added some extra works that wasn't existed in our modeling. That basically turned the model into a piece of trash. And the only solution is to simplify the design, which is already simple enough. Separate it into different parts so then we can stick them together. At this stage, I think it's fair to say that this machine is not reliable if you want to use it to do some heavy tasks. So how about just making some artistic creations? Well, there is a menu in the app which offers you different creative options, but they are either not yet open for use or it's something that requires extra components. Like this character creating, the available options are also very limited. What's interesting is the doll making and pottery art. The first one is very simple. Just take a photo of your face to generate the head model. As for the body, you can pick one of those default ones. The result is surprisingly satisfying, except it doesn't look like the person. Besides, I accidentally found out that one of the default outfits looks exactly the same with my clicks. So I added his head and printed it out. That matched perfectly, isn't it? This is probably the most successful one of all models we have printed.
Какой хороший молодой человек.
The other one, pottery art, will be even simpler. It will offer you a piece of a virtual clay so you can shape it, a vase or bowl as you wish. But you'll find out the problem soon. When reviewing the 3D model, the bottom mouth was too thick, probably because it is automatically generated. But strangely, the bottom of the bottle was the opposite after printed out, and it was already swollen up and seems will crack at any moment. It's nearly impossible to take out the supports inside. And there are some other problems we discovered, even without reasons. For example, the size we designed was according to the actual size we need, but that changed after inputting into the app. The model was supposed to be 5cm wide, but it was somehow increased to 7cm in the app. So if you are expecting to print some dedicated stuff and decorations, this mission will probably let you down. After all the tests we had, I think it's time to make a conclusion. That is, this machine is not matching the description that we saw on the website. It's not that much friendly to the beginners who wants to simplify the complex process by the intelligent operations on the app. It still requires many professional knowledge when actually operating it. It has a relatively slower printing speed, the precision and strength is not satisfying as they told in the introduction, even though we had a couple of successful prints. Moreover, the price you're gonna pay for the resin material is rather an expensive cost. We finished 3 tanks of it to print all the items you have seen in the video. If you are a 3D printing beginner, this printer is obviously not a good choice. And if you are an advanced user, you wouldn't even consider this poor configuration. Therefore, Mijia 3D printer, we give a 3.75 subjective overall scores. Leave your comment under the video, we would like to know your opinion on this product. We hope you enjoy the content, and don't forget to hit the subscribe button so you won't miss anything from this channel. Thanks for watching, I will see you in the next upload.